Welcome to Optical Fiber Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain digital hierarchy, digital transmission hierarchy, and to explain that step by step, I'll explain how digital data that has been getting translated for communication. So, see, basically when we talk about telephonic communication, so in that usually mostly in United States as well as in Canada or in Japan, T1 multiplexing that is so popular and that have been utilized. If you observe T1 multiplexing, in that case you will be finding in T1 multiplexer you will be finding 24 channels are there, and each channel that is having bandwidth of 64 kbps. So when this 24 channels are getting multiplexed, that is resulting into speed of 1.544 Mbps after getting multiplexed. So total 24 separate channels are there that is having pulse code modulation scheme, and by having time division multiplexing, overall speed getting combined to 1.544 Mbps. So this is how T1 multiplexing is getting done. To have T1 multiplexing and transmission of data, usually copper wire is used. Now people are using that with optical cable even, as well as wireless media is even there. So T1 multiplexing that is originated with copper transmission, and now people are using that with optical communication even, as well as wireless communication is popular with this. T1 outstated system has been developed for long distance communication like city to city communication, and it is common for internet access provider to connect it with internet as point of presence POP, and T1 line owned by majority with telephone network. So you'll be finding like in India with BSNL even T1 multiplexing has been getting done, and speed of that is available with each channel of 64 kbps, and 24 channels with one single multiplexer is resulting into 1.544 mbps speed. So this is what about T1 multiplexing. Now if you go further with hierarchy, then you'll be finding after T1 multiplexing there is T2 multiplexer, where in T2 multiplexer you'll be finding 4 channels that is getting combined, and each of having 1.544 mbps. So total output of that T2 multiplexer that is 6.312 mbps. So after T1 multiplexing there is T2 multiplexer, and that is what making that bandwidth to 6.312 mbps with the combination of 4 output of T1 multiplexer. So as we have seen it in previous slide, T1 multiplexer is having output which is about 1.544 mbps. So if you combine these 4 channels in T2 multiplexer, you will be finding that speed is 6.312, and T2 multiplexers that is been utilized with optical fiber. So here when you have that transmission of T2 multiplexer, you will be finding optical fibers are getting utilized for that. Now if we see further hierarchy, then after T2 multiplexer there is T3 multiplexer. So 7 channels of output of T2 multiplexer that is getting combined, and that is making it to the speed of 44.736 mbps. So 7 channels of T3 multiplexer that is making it to 44.736 mbps speed. So total if you observe T3 multiplexer that is having 672 telephone channels, and if you observe that for T2 multiplexer, then you'll be finding 96 telephone channels that is getting connected with T2 multiplexing, while in case of T3 multiplexing we can have connection of 672 number of telephone channels, and that one can see it by this hierarchy. In T1 24 channels are there with one multiplexer, and output of T1 that is what we are connecting it to T2, and in T2 we have multiplexing of 4 T1 output, so that is making bandwidth to 6.312 mbps, and in T3 output of T2 with 7 channels is getting connected, and that is making bandwidth up to 44.736 mbps. And then after in hierarchy we can see T4 multiplexer, And in T4 multiplexer, we have 6 T3 output connection, and that is making speed of 274.176 Mbps. And here one can observe, we can have 4032 number of telephone channels. So by having T4 connection, we can have 4032 telephone channels, and that is what we are transferring it with T4 connection. And in T4 connection, usually we have optical communication only. So optical fibers are connected in telephone network to have a connection of this many number of telephone channels, like 4032 number of channels. So this is what about hierarchy. And now one can clearly understand, initially we have discussed about T1 multiplexer, where I have told, like, initially copper wire have been utilized, but at that time there was a speed of 64 kbps, right? And then we have connected that to T2 multiplexer, where speed was increased, and that is 6.312 mbps. And then 7 channels of T2 output is getting connected, is making it to T3 multiplexer, which is having speed of 44.736 mbps. And after T4 multiplexing with 6 channels, input with speed of 44.736 is making it to 274.176 mbps. So as if you go in this direction with hierarchy, you will be finding bandwidth is increasing, and as bandwidth increases, one can observe we need to have such media where we have larger bandwidth, and based on larger bandwidth, one can have that connection with proper bandwidth as well as data transfer. So we use optical fiber as we go with higher bandwidth hierarchy. I hope that you have understood what is the role of optical fiber. See, in copper wire communication, one can have lower bandwidth, but in optical fiber, we have larger bandwidth available with single connection. And as you have broad connection of telephone network, as we have seen it for T4 multiplexer case, where 4032 means 4032 number of telephone connections are required to have bandwidth of 274.176 mbps. So where we can have that speed with optical fiber connection, and that is where optical connection is so critical. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you have understood this hierarchy, what is the role of optical fiber here. Ultimate agenda is to increase bandwidth by using optical fiber without having interference with multiple channel, and that is what we can have it by having multiple optical connection. And nowadays people are using that, and probably in future even people will be having this requirement, and this will be increasing day by day. Thank you so much for watching this video. Definitely you can give your valuable suggestions, and based on it in future I'll make videos. Thank you so much.